partner name?
Bello.
Bello. Bello and Blacker immortalized that tree and wrote a song. And that became almost a kind of hit song from campus for that tree there. Now, for the students at this campus, they know which tree they're talking about. For the people who have visit, it's a tree around the corner.
That's such your life.
It's a tree around the corner. That's all. Now, you see, for the people who say, yeah, just set your life, understand.
We know a wisdom tree and we know
you know the history of it?
Which
is the first name?
Well, the first name, I know it says wisdom tree, the first name here, but no, there was a name before that still.
The first name was Ganja tree.
Ganja tree, but we know what called that.
You know what called that? That was the first official name. It was called Ganja tree. Now, what they don't know about the ganja tree, and then one day we come down and yeah, me and said let me start euphemize the ganja tree and start call it wisdom tree. One day we go over art school and I ask for a man and them say, yeah, I'm over Amsterdam. and we are talking about and, well now it named the tree of life. Now I feel so that is a central thing that I should use for kind of introduce Gene. Because Gene are the people who dubbed that the ganja tree. That was their tree. When Gene ended their drama school, that was where, same purpose now, because when people hear Tree of Life, I'm a wrestler, I want them to be a wrestler, I pay a ganja them meat and smoke.
Which is mostly true.
But that's not it. You know, the man them meet over there, if you ever pass through and see when the man them gather, them discuss politics, them discuss the court, you know, the world, them discuss world politics, local politics, them write poems.
Religion.
And lately I hear that religion is added to the whole thing.
Drums.
See, no.
Drums.
Drums were always there. See, drums were always there. We still have drums,
of course. We have red threads and resident drum, and we have full before we drum.
All right. Them man are the current man, them occupy the tree here. So now for link up. Now, this is how the tree was. It was always a tree where people meet and then discuss who for going up, who will try next as government. It seemed like a very powerful tree because when we met there, we really felt like we were shaping the country. You know, we really felt like we could dictate what the policies should be, the national policies, and we really felt like...
And we still are.
And we still are.
Yes, yes.
So nothing has changed.
Nothing.
But I just want to know, sir, this tree was birthed by the light, by the featured guest who we have tonight.
I know.
And I have a pure respect for that, for no, sir. Look, them people come and them start a tradition. And this is like about 30 years ago we are talking about, you know. And that tradition there lives on today with the same fervor, with the same validity, and the same sense of purpose, the same urgency that it had then. And for you who don't know that tree there, whether you call it Amsterdam, the tree of life or whatever, at some point, we must check it out. And I know it's in years to come when things kind of change and things, that people will be making pilgrimages from abroad to come down here to go to that tree, to say, yeah, what is it about this tree?
They already do.
You know, if you have a tree where you can have Oko, you know, Gene, Mikey Smith, you know, Sage, Ganja, Debbie. If you have all of them people that gather under this tree, there must be something about this tree. So it is this tree now, I'm hoping to kind of, without saying, mention as a kind of metaphor for say, look, Gene is one of the people who is the root, and she planted this tree of activism, of speaking out, of finding your own voice. And that tree, they still live on the campus. All of them people who mentioned were students here at the same time. As I said, that's something we still can't get over. And all of these people were pioneers in claiming the reclamation of a voice, of our own voice, as children of the diaspora, of children who understood that we belonged, our claim belonged long before the diaspora, that our civilization, our claims was long before the Arabian invasion that took over the pyramids them and lick off the Sphinx nose. That we go way beyond that. That we were the people who traveled to the Caribbean and went back and told people in Spain, say, yo, the planet, you know, flat, you know. That we're talking about a civilization that go way back. That all the scientists, them, black, white, yellow, and pink, and whatever color, have decided that, yeah, life started in Africa and civilization started there and knowledge started there, and that all of this is our birthright. And sometimes we forget, and sometimes we speak like we are descendants of slaves, but we aren't. You know, we're long before that. And the only time that we actually come to that and that full realization is when we really claim it. We come up and start living and realize, hey, we have to reclaim our voice, we have to reclaim our identity. And these are the people who kept that alive, kept that echo alive, that echo that distant. We aren't children of slaves, we are from long before that. And we have the fire to prove it. And the fire, Gene, it still live, and we're really happy to celebrate that fire tonight by having here.
I just want to say that if you pass by that tree in the still of the night and you hear a little rustling in the leaves, it's a breeze.
Boys in society, join me. I consider it an honor, and I mean, I hope people can really fully appreciate what it is to have Gene here tonight. Gene, let's celebrate your presence tonight. This is an honor that you come to me, and the honor that you have. So, we are here to honor the inner of God. Gene, yes. Gene, Binta, Breeze.
My voice is not very strong. Just a few months ago, I had two strokes. Left me in hospital in a lot of damage to my lungs. So now I have to be very careful with my voice. So forgive me if I don't.